Hello everyone, welcome to the class. Today we are going to talk about ABO blood grouping. We have another system also of the blood group, that is RH group. So in today's lecture we are going to focus on the ABO blood grouping. This ABO blood group system was proposed by, or we can say discovered by, the scientist Land Steiner. Okay, he gave the blood group A, B and O, and the blood group AB was discovered by Descastillo and Stirling. Okay, these are the scientists who are associated with the discovery of the blood groups of the system ABO. Fine. So when we are going to talk about the blood group ABO system, we have this particular concept is related to the multiple allelism. Okay, in our grade 10 we have read the concept of inheritance of the character. So the blood group is one of them. The blood groups are inherited from the parents. Okay, and for inheritance, the characters which are expressed in our body, genes are responsible for it. So that genes, they have their alternative forms which we call allele. Fine. So the blood group, when we are talking about blood group, is a character. So this blood group is having more than two alleles which are responsible for different phenotypic effects. Okay, different types of blood groups: blood group A, blood group B, AB and O. So all those four types blood groups are different because of the presence of the three alleles over there. Out of the three, two possible combinations will be there. So as the alleles which are involved in this inheritance are more than two, for that this is a multiple allelism. This is the example of multiple allele concept. Got it? So the alleles which are responsible for this is IA, IB and II. Okay, these are the three alleles. Got it? Now we will talk about the possibilities of the genotypes and the phenotypes for various types of the blood groups. Let's talk about that. If I talk about blood group A, so the genotype which should be responsible for that can be two. One is a homozygous, that is IA and IA, and second one be this combination, the heterozygous condition. Got it? Now, to understand this, we must know that A blood group, B blood group, these are the dominant one, and this is also dominant. Blood group O is recessive. Okay, dominant is which one? Which will express in both the states. Either it is homozygous or it is heterozygous. The A is dominant, so the blood group will be A. Blood group will be A. If it is, that is the case of B, then B will be dominant, so the blood group will be B. But for the O, the recessive allele should present to express the O phenotype. Fine. So this is the possible genotype. Okay, two genotypes are responsible. Like if this is the combination, then also A blood group. If this is the combination, then also blood group A. So for blood group B, the combinations will be as I told you, B is dominant. So this is the homozygous condition, or this can also be. In both the cases, the blood group will be B. For AB, IA should also present, IB also should present, because both are dominant. Okay, and as the both are showing the dominance, this is known as codominance. This is the example of codominance. Co means together, together they are dominant, that's where they are giving AB blood group. Fine. Next one, to have this O blood group, the genotype must be recessive, and this is the possible recessive genotype. Fine. So we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. We have 6 genotype. And what are the phenotypes? That is the physical characters which are appeared. So blood group A, blood group B, AB and O. So how many blood groups we have got as a result of these combinations? We have got 4 types. So there are 4 phenotypes. Okay? 6 genotypes means 6 combinations are there to get the 4 different types of blood group. So, in the case of the blood group, 6 genotypes, 4 phenotypes. Okay, genotype is the genetic constitution, that genetic makeup. This is the genotype, IA, IA, this one. Okay, and phenotype is this, what we are getting as a expression of this particular gene. So, we are getting blood group A, this is phenotype. Clear? Now we'll see what is going to determine the type of the blood group. There are two particular substances. Okay, if I'm going to say what is responsible for blood groups, different blood groups, so the answer would be the presence of antigen A and the B. Two antigens are there. Their presence will decide the type of the blood group. Either the blood group is A or the blood group is B. Got it? Antigens are what? Antigens are the foreign particles which are entering into the body to stimulate the immune response of our body. Got it? So on the surfaces of red blood cells, antigens are present where? Yes, they are always present on red blood cells surface. Got it? And when these antigens are going to present, naturally our body is going to produce the another kind of the substance which we call antibody. In response of antigen. Okay, generally antibodies kab produce hote hain, jab koi body mein antigen enter karta hai usko wahi pe block karne ke liye. Theek hai? So antibodies are always formed against the antigen. to destroy it, to stop it action in that way. So antibodies will present, where they will present? Present in blood plasma. Got it? So because of the presence of these two factors, the antigen and the antibody, that we're going to decide the type of the blood group. And what are those antigen? Either the A antigen or the B, or both can also present, or none of them can also present. Their presence or their absence will decide the type of the blood groups in human being. Fine, let's see how it will be determined. So we'll talk about blood group A. Blood group B, blood group AB and O. Fine. So over here, this blood group A, B and AB is determined by the presence of antigen on the red blood cells. So these are the red blood cells. Red blood cells of three different person of different blood groups. So here we'll see what is going to be present. We're going to denote A antigen, okay, and B antigen. And where the antigen they should present, they will present on the surface of the red blood cell. If the person is having blood group A, it means the red blood cells, what they are going to contain? They will contain the antigen A. Got it? Antigen A is present. And this antigen A, which is present on the surface of red blood cells, it is going to determine, this is the red blood cells which contain antigen on the RBC surface. This decides that the blood group is A, A blood type. Fine. A present in the blood group is A. Now, in the plasma of the blood, the plasma contain which type of antibody? If the antibody is A, if I'll say, I'll represent with a small letter. If antibody is A and that antibody is produced against the antigen A, so obviously it is going to destroy that. Fine. So whenever the antibodies will present, that will be contrasting over, that will be the alternative of that. Okay. So here this antibody which will present, that is B type. So that how we are going to write that? In the blood plasma, anti-B is present, antibody B is present. So this is the situation of the person who is having blood group A. Its RBC contain antigen A and the blood plasma contain antibody B. Then the blood group is A. Fine. And the person who is having the blood group B, the RBCs of that person contain antigen B on the surface of red blood cells. Got it? RBCs contain antigen B. Fine. So, the blood group of the person will be B type. B antigen B blood group. And the plasma of this person will contain antibody A to form that complex of antibody antigen, then the A antibody is present. If B will present, then it will destroy the B antigen. Got it? And then there will be no compatibility of the blood groups. The blood group, the RBC starts destroying in that way. So that's why there is different than that of the antigen. B antigen, B blood group. A antigen, A blood group. Now, the condition, the person who is having AB blood group. So, this person, red blood cells contain both B antigen also and along with the A antigen. Okay, this RBCs, they are containing A antigen also, B antigen also. So as I have told you, their presence or absence will decide the type of the blood group. And in this case, both are present. So the blood group will be AB type. Because antigen A is also present, antigen B is also present. Now the plasma of this person is going to contain what type of antibody? If A will present, then A antigen will be destroyed. If B is present, then B antigen is destroyed. So, there is no antigen, no antibody is present in the AB blood group plasma. Fine. So, these are the three A, B and AB blood types. Now, we'll talk about the fourth blood group. That is blood group O. The condition, that is the fourth type, blood group O. This person's red blood cells, what they are going to contain? It will not contain any type of antigen. No antigen. Reason? If antigen A is present, then blood group A will be there. If antigen B is present, blood group B will be there. If both are present, then AB will be there. So this particular blood group will be determined when there is no antigen. It means there is no such gene dominant which will form the antigens. So that condition is possible only in the case of the recessive, where there is no functional antigen, or we can say functional gene is there to form the antigens. Kisi bhi tarike ka koi bhi antigen form nahi hoga blood group O mein. Okay, because we are talking only about A or B type of antigens. And they are going to decide the type A, B and AB. So in the case of blood group O, there will be no antigen. But the person of this particular blood group contain the antibody A also and antibody B also. Got it? Now we will see, because of the presence of these particular antigen antibody, the blood groups have been determined. We'll see the compatibility, we'll see that who can give blood to whom and who can take blood from whom. Okay, we'll see the recipient and the donor by making a tabulated form of all the content which we have discussed till now. Okay, in that case, the recapitulation will be also there. So first is blood group. Then what type of antigen is present? What type of antibodies are present? Who will be the donor? Who will be the recipient? Fine. blood group A, blood group B, blood group AB and blood group O. Got it? This one is dominant. AG dominant, B is also dominant. This is the example of co-dominants. It means A and B both are dominant. And O is the example of recessive blood. Got it? Now, the type of the antigens which are going to present. The antigen which is present in blood group A is A. Antigen which is present in blood group B is B. AB and no antigen. Got it? Because the presence of antigen A and B will decide the type of blood group. So over here there is no antigen. A antigen, it means A antibody should not be there. So antibody B, antibody A. No antibody, because that can destroy A also or B also, if either of these, any of these can present over here. And in this case, both will present because there is no antigen. Fine. So as a result of this, the person who is having blood group A can give blood group to A. Okay? The person of the blood group A can donate the blood to the person who is having blood group A. He can be the donor to the A only and can receive the blood from O also and blood group A also. Got it? Fine. We'll just find out the reason behind that and then let me know that. B blood group person can give blood to B. Okay? This person can donate the blood to the person who is having the blood group B only and can receive the blood group from O blood group person and of the B person. Got it? This person who is having the blood group AB, to whom the person can donate? Only to the person AB. Okay? And as it is having antigen A also, antigen B also, so it can receive from all. Okay? It can receive from all the blood groups. So as a result, it is a universal recipient. This particular person who is having blood group O is not having any antigen but have these antibodies A and B. This person can give blood to anyone because there is no antigen. Antigen nahi to koi bhi person isko foreign detect karega hi nahi. So can donate to all the bloods. Okay, we'll see that. AB positive and O negative exactly. O RH mein hum decide karenge. So to all, this is a universal donor. This is a universal donor blood. Fine. And recipient from whom it can take the blood. If it were going to take from A, then A antibody will destroy. If it will take from B, then B will destroy. If it will take from AB, then both will destroy. It means it can take only from the person who is having the blood group of O. Got it? This is about the different types of blood groups. Fine. So this we have discussed about the different types of the blood group. So what is responsible for blood group? Let me recapitulate once. The ABO blood group system, which is having four different types of blood group, A, B, AB and O. All these are decided by the presence of antigen A or the presence of antigen B. Got it? And in the plasma, ye kahan par honge? On RBC and the antibody, which are generated against the antigen, they will present in plasma. And which type of antibody will present? Which are different from the antigen. Okay, so that it will not destroy and disturb the RBCs over there. So as a result, different types of blood groups are decided. AB blood group, universal recipient. O blood group, universal donor. Fine. Thank you. If any queries, then let me know about that.